Welcome. So we are going to start with chemical gum. And this is a chemical gum. We are also going to discuss on how to use this Shoemaker super glue to finish our work. So these are the two things we are going to start with. And remember that anything that is synthetic, you are going to use a chemical gum for that. Either as an insole or as a sole, you use a chemical gum. So let's go into practical on how to use a chemical gum. I'll be right back. So this is what we call a chemical gum. You can see it is a crystal clear in color, and this is what we call a stiffener. So we are going to mix this stiffener with the chemical gum. Most people don't know that they have to mix the gum with a stiffener. So it is very important that you mix your chemical gum with the stiffener and you measure the quantity that will make the stiffener to be active. So for the chemical gum to be active enough, you have to mix a little quantity with the stiffener, and some people call this hardener, so whichever one you call it. So you make sure you measure a quantity that will be able to, you know, make the gum active. So after mixing the two together, you turn it very well to mix together very well. You stir it properly. Before then, you must have grinded the surface of your rubber sole. You must have grinded it to make it rough. So, and then you apply the gum on the surface of the sole. And you have to be careful in order not to spill the gum on the outside of the sole, understand? So it will help you to achieve a very neat finishing. So you take your time and apply the gum on the sole. So after properly applying gum on the rubber sole, making sure that you the gum touched all the area necessary, you also apply on your insole, understand? So now you can see the gum have dried. You have to allow it to dry. It is no longer sticky, understand? It's no longer sticky, you see it. So you have to allow it to dry, and then the stove is already on. You can see the source of our heat. We're using a stove, so you can use whatsoever source of heat, either gas or any other source of heat, but we are going to use stove in this case. So you pick the sole, you begin to move it around the heat. have to move it, make sure that the heat touches all the angles of the sole. Make sure you're not leaving any side untouched. So you move it until you can feel the heat on your hand, and then you pick the other part, which is the insole, and then you do the same, and then you gum the sole to the insole. So you have to take your time to fix the sole to make sure it is well fixed. And then one mistake that most people do is that they hammer the sole. No, you have to press. You have to press exact pressure on it. You have to exert pressure on it. You don't hammer it. So you do it right around the sole. You press it, compress it. If you have a pressing machine, you can use that. But if not, you can just simply exert pressure on the sole. Then as you're doing that, the gum is cooling off. And as it is cooling off, that is when it is even bonding more. So you keep on exerting pressure around the sole and the center to make sure that the two surfaces, you know, merges effectively. So after that, you can see the sole have been attached. You can see that. So that is all on this step. Now this is a super glue. We are going to cut off the pointed mouth. You can see that we cut it a bit short. We're going to use a hack here. So this is injection pin. So I'm also going to cut it short too. You see, and I'm going to tie it to that cover. I'm going to make sure it is very tight. You can see that, and then I'm going to tie it to the can of the glue. The reason we are doing this is to achieve a neat finished bonding. So I'm trying to make sure it is flowing. Now I'm going to use it to complete the places at the edges where the gum was not able to catch. So I'm going to do it right round. So that is the major work of this glue. It helps you to finish the edges of your footwear. It is not limited to shoes. You can use it for any footwear at all. So that is that on these two glues. We're going to move over to the next one.
So welcome back. Just know that each time you used a synthetic leather to wrap up your insole, or you are using a rubber sole, just know that you are going to use a chemical gum to couple that footwear. So let's go into a multi-purpose gum, which is the yellow gum we know. Some people use Nora to make their soles. It is not advisable. The reason is, when you use Nora to make your footwear, when the customer wears it, when there's weight on that footwear. As the customer or the person is working with the footwear, there is friction in between the two. You know, they are two hard surfaces. So once there is that friction, after some time, the gum will fail. And another disadvantage again is that water can easily get in between the sole and the insole if it is during the rainy season. You understand? So to avoid that, you need to put marco in between the two knurls. It doesn't matter the millimeter of marco you wish to use. You can use 2 millimeters, you can use 4, you can use 6, depending on what you are looking at to get. If you look closely on this footwear, though it has been worn, you see it has been worn for some time now. So I just want to use it to show us the example. If you look at the edge of this footwear now, you see that it is well bonded. You won't have a gap after filing the footwear. And this marco now will not allow water to get into the in between the sole and the insole easily. And the marco also serves as a shock absorber, you understand? Instead of friction to occur in between these two components, that is the sole and the insole, the marco will hold it, will hold the bond. So it serves as a shock absorber. And another thing is that marco is 100% adaptive to bonding. That is sure. You understand? That is sure. So another thing is that there's a way you're going to use iron brush to brush the surface of your marco. You know, most of the marco we have in the market today, they are foreign marcos and their surfaces are very smooth. So you don't have to use them that way, that they are smooth. If you apply gum on a smooth surface, like you see here is smooth. If you apply gum, the gum won't, that is, the bonding won't last for long. So what you're going to do is that anytime you come across any material that has a smooth surface, you roughen it, either with your sandpaper or with your grinding machine. Then for marco, you don't need to use your grinding machine on your marco because it is going to spoil it. So what you're going to do is you're going to use this iron brush to brush the surface of the marco front and back to give it a rough surface. So and after brushing the surface, make sure that there is no oil or water on the two surfaces you are coupling. You understand? Make sure there is no water in between the two surfaces. So another thing is that the marco, when you are putting marco, when you are attaching marco in between your sole and your insole, the marco has to come before your lasting. You understand? That is what you're seeing here now. The marco has to come, then your lasting has to be on the marco so that it will give you that super bond that you are aiming at. So that is on that. So once you are sure that there is no water or oil or other impurity on the surfaces of those two components you are about to couple together, then you can apply your gum. And another thing is to take note of it. At the end of the video, you are going to see some, you know, video example on how to do the brushing and also how to apply your gum. You don't apply gum some places, you apply a thick layer and some you apply a light layer. Make sure you apply your gum evenly, a uniform layer. You understand? Make sure that your gum, the gum you applied in each surface is on is a uniform layer. Let there not be some parts are thick layer, the other parts are, you know, tiny or light layer. It doesn't work that way. So you have to take note of that. So like I said before, our marco is 100% adaptive to bonding. So you're looking forward to get a long-lasting bond, make sure you use a macro of any millimeter at all you wish to use. Then, another thing you need to put into consideration is the type of gum you are using. You know, some of these products, in this case, I'm also going to advise us to always use original brand. Make sure you are using a quality gum. Now, most of these gum, some of them are thick, some are light. That is depending on the product. So if you are using a light brand, you have to wait from, let's say, 5 minutes and above for it to activate. Then if you are using a thick brand, you have to wait for like from 10 minutes and above for it to activate. And how do you know that the gum has activated for bonding? After applying your gum on the surface and you have waited for like 5 or 10 minutes, depending on the product you are using, the thickness. Once you touch the flat surface and the gum is no longer sticking to your finger, once you touch it and it is no longer sticky, it means that the gum has been activated. You understand? You can now bond that good one. Then, another thing is, one of the biggest mistakes most of us make is using our iron metal hammer to, you know, trying to make sure that there is proper bonding between our sole and our insole. It is okay, but it is not the best. You understand? Because once you are hitting the hammer on the insole or on the outsole, instead of the bond to go in to bond properly, the sole or the insole will be bouncing out. You understand? Because it is a metal hammer. So in that case, what you should have is a mallet. You tap your mallet on the sole or the insole, depending on the one you prefer, you know, giving pressure on to make the bond strong. So as you are tapping it, the two components will bond. Instead of the sole or the insole to bounce, the mallet will bounce. You know, it is made of rubber, so that is why you have to use a mallet. Another advantage of using a mallet is this: after using it on your insole or your sole, it won't leave mark. You understand? It won't leave any mark or trace on the sole or the outsole. And also, even when you hit it on your leather, it won't give it any damage. So these are the few things that I wish to share with you in this video. I don't want to go into other people's view and opinion. You know, there's a lot of views and opinion in this issue of gum, but I'm speaking to you based on my experience, experiment, and observations. So at the end of this video, you're going to just see a brief video on how you can brush your macro and how you are going to apply your gum. So I think this is where I am going to end this tutorial. If you have any question, you are free to drop your questions. So thank you, and we shall meet again next time. Have a nice day.
So make sure you brush the macro properly with your iron brush. You can get this iron brush where they are selling building material tools. So you make sure you brush the macro front and back to roughen the surface. Then as you apply your gum, make sure that you apply a uniform layer. So apply a uniform layer.